All right, everyone, it's time for more March Makeover Madness. We're really excited about this. So joining us now is Nathan Mersereau, certified financial planner and president of Planning Alternatives, Wealth Advisors for Life in Bloomfield Hills. Thank you for being here.
Thank you for having me.
So you're going to be with us every Thursday, right, teaching us more and more and more. And now we're making over all of our finances through various strategies, and this is a really good one. What is the best way to protect your finances? We're going to learn, and what does it mean to actually protect, right?
Right. We're getting a lot of information right now as tax filing season is here, so we need to safeguard our personal information, and we need to safeguard our identity.
Okay, great. So let us roll with the questions. We created a little game for you guys to keep this fun because this is heavy material, but I'd like to also let you know now, and I'll let you know later, we have a comprehensive checklist on the Live in the D page of clickondetroit.com, so this will all be there for you. Don't worry. So let's get into our game.
So I'm going to ask you questions.
Yes.
Okay.
And they're going to cover how long to keep financial records.
Okay. All right. You ready?
Yeah, I'm ready.
All right.
So first question, how long should you keep tax information, bank statements, and canceled checks? A, discard them after a year, short term, 1 to 3 years, medium term, 6 to 7 years, or long term?
The answer is C.
The answer is C. Good job, Blaine.
Wow.
Yes.
Oh,
my dad taught me that.
Okay.
That's excellent.
Okay.
The IRS actually can audit up to 3 years,
yep.
But if you underreport your income, they have until 6 years to track you down.
Oh boy, there you go.
Nice. All right.
So what's the second question?
Second question, how long should you keep records like household bills, paycheck stubs, and expired insurance policies?
Expired
A,
insurance
B, C,
policies.
Or D?
I would say, no, I would say B. I would keep them for a little while, short term, 1 to 3 years.
You are exactly right.
Okay.
You guys are
killing
it.
Thank you.
Yeah.
Thank you.
1 to 1.
Good.
There
if
we go.
If anything ever goes wrong, you want to keep your records so that you can go back, double check them. The good news is that more and more things are going online now, so it's becoming a little bit easier to retrieve your records.
Okay.
All right, third question. How long should you keep investment records, medical history information, and retirement plan contribution information?
Shredded after a day?
You know, that would
no.
I don't think that's on the list.
No. I would definitely go with long-term indefinitely.
You're exactly right.
Okay,
really?
Great.
Nailed it again.
Wow.
Really? How
Good
long
job.
Did you think you'd keep
I don't
it
know.
For?
My wife handles all this stuff.
Oh, boy.
Stuff.
Here we go.
Yeah.
Okay.
Seriously. When you buy a stock, if you are going to sell it in the future, you need to have evidence of what you paid for that investment.
Okay.
And also, when you add to retirement accounts, you need to have evidence of what went in there.
All right.
All right. Final question. And this is a really important one. Which of the following social media posts can make you vulnerable to an attack? A, birth announcement.
I got this.
B, your home address.
Okay.
C, loss of a loved one. D, your child's birthday.
All of the above.
You guys are on fire.
I would say that,
all of the above.
You have
all
to be careful
above.
About what you put on there, right?
Yeah.
Your address. That's all you need. Date of birth, address, and someone's name,
or,
and you can wreak havoc.
Or any one of the above.
Right.
Really.
Right.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
Absolutely.
Right.
There are more and more instances of people's identity being stolen,
right.
And a lot of it is being done through social media.
Wow.
People just trolling.
Yes.
Yeah.
Yes.
Looking at Facebook pages.
So when you're out at Disney World with your grandkids, don't go posting that you're there and saying, come on in, robbers. The house is open.
Exactly.
Do your post.
We got a brand new 40-inch TV.
Yeah.
Exactly.
Come and get it.
Room.
Come and get
exactly.
it.
Exactly. So protecting your identity is a critical thing to protecting your finances.
Perfect. Nathan, thank you so much
thank
for
you.
Being here. Remember, if you want more information on protecting your finances, we've put a complete checklist on our Live in the D page at clickondetroit.com. You guys got to check it out.